Hello mates, and welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to talk about two well-known technologies, Ruby on Rails and Node.js. In fact, we will compare them. Let's get down to it. Let's consider both technologies' advantages and disadvantages before making any conclusions. Ruby on Rails is a framework based on Ruby language. It was created in 2004 and often called just Rails. Nobody liked bugs in their apps, neither the end users nor the developers. Ruby on Rails technologies has stakes in bug-free products, so it has testing tool called Minitest. This tool provides developers with such testing facilities as benchmarking, mocking, TDD, and BDD. If you strictly follow the TDD and BDD approaches, they will help you to test all the project's code and provide you with the well-thought-out architecture. This way, the Rails-based projects tend to have code that is easy to read, maintain, and test. This framework contains a lot of ready-made solutions like plugins and various modules. That fact leads to a faster development process and helps to avoid writing boilerplate code. Another factor contributing to Ruby on Rails' time efficiency is the presence of Module View Controller. With its help, several developers can work on a project simultaneously by sharing their responsibilities. Thus, one of them has an opportunity to work on controllers, while another can be focused on models or views. It is vital to take care of the number of requests your project is able to cope with in advance. Ruby on Rails has good scaling potential due to its modularity. For example, one of the famous companies that use Ruby on Rails is Shopify, that processes around 4 million requests every second. Rails has a variety of security-related features that are enabled from the very beginning of framework usage. At the same time, Ruby on Rails usage requires a necessity to follow such complex processes as security development lifecycle. Node.js is a platform written in JavaScript. Node.js lets developers build web servers and even networking tools. By the way, watch our video related to the importance of usage of open source libraries in your project. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel in order to watch our videos one of the first. Being powered by Google's V8 engine, Node technology demonstrates a really high running speed. One more interesting thing about Node.js is that it allows running the code written by coders much faster, increasing the speed of any framework. Both HTTP queries and responses are perceived as isolated events, but in fact they are actually streaming data. Data streaming with Node.js really looks better, so developers can feel Node.js advantages when implementing something like processing files during their upload. Having a number of efficient features, Node.js can be used to proxy a certain amount of services that have some differences related to response time. Also, they can be used for streaming data from various sources. By means of Node.js development, programmers have an opportunity to write both client-side and server-side. That fact contributes a lot to time efficiency since it allows sending and synchronizing data easily between these two sites. Node.js performance has raised dramatically for the last 4 years, leaving Ruby far behind in some peculiar cases. The job market also shows that Ruby on Rails technology is losing its position, while Node development, in contrary, continues to strengthen its position yearly. For instance, LinkedIn has replaced their backend built on Ruby on Rails by Node.js because of reasons related to performance and scalability. This way, the company managed to increase the performance for certain scenarios up to 20 times and reduce the load on the servers. Ruby on Rails is quite flexible and can be ported to any platform by means of database migration. From other hand, Ruby on Rails requires a lot of processing power and its speed is relatively slow. Node.js has powerful basic libraries, it is fast and easy to support. Add to this the ability of language to deal with both client and server side, the fact it's demanded on the market. However, drawbacks are also present, for example, its unstable API and the lack of developers on the market. As for us, we prefer using Node.js for our projects. We have an extensive experience of work with these technologies and we like its technical aspects, like the speed and the fact it's asynchronous, so we can do several operations simultaneously while querying. That's all for now. If you want to get more details, read our article. subscribe to our channel, and join us if you're curious about technologies. See you later!